Okay. We're going to do something really cool here, guys. I'm not going to even tell you what we're doing until it's done. Anyway, I've got hearts of palm. I've got breadcrumbs, panko crumbs. I have nori sheet crumbled. I have 2 tablespoons of vegan mayonnaise. I have some Old Bay seasoning and some salt here. And that's our ingredients for the first part of this go. So let's see what comes next, okay? Okie dokie. So we take our hearts of palm, drop those into the blender. Our panko breadcrumbs into the blender. Our nori seaweed. Drop that into the blender. And our mayonnaise and Old Bay sea chunks in it even. Okay, let's see what's next. We need to get... Well, I was going to get some parchment paper, but I seem to be out of parchment paper. I just love it when that happens. I've got an alternative over here, probably. Let's see. Thought I did anyway. Oh, there they are. I do have alternatives. They're air fryer liners, but that will work in a pinch. Okay, put that out on a plate. Now you're gonna get your hands in, so make sure you're all washed up like you should be, because you're gonna get your hands in this, and you're gonna make pushing it, you know, make little shapes about what you want the shape of these things to be, and put them on a plate. I'll give you a little heads up. We're going to be battering these in just a little bit after they set up and cool a little bit in the fridge. And yeah, and so that gives you an idea about the shapes you might want. Get your hands into the work here. Okay. And we'll come back in a minute when we get ready for that. Okay. So what you end up with, something that looks like that. And you're gonna put these in the fridge to let them set up and get ready for the batter that's going to happen shortly. And I got 2 plates out of here. Well, not complete, about a plate and a half. And we'll see what's next. Okay, now we're going to make the batter. And we've got 1.5 cups of all-purpose flour. You've got your spice mixture, which I'll put all below on the recipe. I'll list it. There we go. And then I chose a Guinness Extra Stout for my beer batter. And we want, let me see. We want 1.5 cups of Guinness Stout or the beer you prefer to use. I think this gives it a very good flavor. 1.5 cups. kind of hard to tell that if I've got 1.5 cups with a beer that froths up like that. We'll take it where we can get it. Okay. Whisk that on up real good into a batter. Oops. Oh yeah. Bubbling and going. It's gonna be a crispy batter. The colder your beer is that you make the beer batter with, the crispier your batter will turn out whenever it fries. And I knew we were going to need just a bit more. That foam took up a lot. But make it into a good batter that you can dip into. Oh, yeah. Oh yeah, that's looking really good. That's going to be nice. Okay. Let's get ready to rumble. Okay, now we want to get our pan and our oil. As hot as the fires of Vesuvius. Well, maybe not that hot. But then we take our wonderful creations and we batter them up. Batter them up. And then we pop them into the pan. About 3 minutes on each side, I think, or somewhere close to that. You can judge that. Batter's a little thick. And here's what we accomplished. This is vegan fish. And I will post the recipe below. I'm getting ready to sample it. And I want to show you something specifically that I find rather fascinating about vegan fish, like this, made like this. With hearts of palm. There we go. And the specific thing I want to show you is the texture. The texture is almost 100% like fish. Wonderful. Wonderful. So you don't have to give up all this kind of stuff. You don't have to give up the stuff you love. It can almost all be duplicated naturally and healthy. This is one your whole family won't even know if you switch it on them, because the texture is exactly like fish sticks or something like that. Anyway, okay guys, see ya.